Hello learners, welcome to the Smart Learning platform of Odisha State Open University. At the outset, I do congratulate you for taking this leadership program, because this program is basically been designed to enable you to embark on the paths of personal and professional leadership development. I am Dr. Lalatendu Keshari Jenna, and in this episode, we are going to discuss about emotional intelligence and leadership. Let's first of all explore whether having an emotion is important when we sit in the position of a leadership. Emotions is integral. It's a very burning topic. You know, every individual has its own emotions. But do those emotions matter when we are sitting in a corporate position, especially in a leadership position? It is standing to be a burning topic. Emotions are good. Having it is what we have been gifted with it, we can say. But how to intelligently drive that emotion is what is a burning topic. Basically, we need to know over here what exactly is an emotion and how is it playing out in the context of leadership. Emotions is a very important area to understand, especially in terms of emotional intelligence. It's to be a very burning topic in terms of leadership traits. Generally, at this point of time, when you are referring about emotions and the criteria of emotions, we are supposed to know what exactly is emotional intelligence. And further to it, we need to explore how it is actually building the context of leadership. Emotional intelligence, let's explore the definition. Emotional intelligence has to do with one's own ability to manage one's own emotion, and accordingly we can leverage the emotions suitably basing on the situations where you are in now. So emotional intelligence talks about, first of all, to understand or to explore what ability we have to check our own emotions, and then we need to see what situations we are in, and in that situation how we are connecting to our emotions. It also has to do with a kind of one's awareness and a kind of sensitivity towards others' emotions. This is also important. We need to be very sensitive to understand others. When we know about our own emotions, we are also supposed to know about how others are acting to it. Are you being aware about others' emotions? Are you being sensitive to others' emotions? Therefore, it has to do with one's consciousness. Consciousness means when somebody has an internal consciousness to understand the emotion. And the second one is to be compassionate towards others' emotions, to understand others' emotions. Therefore, it could effortlessly be argued that emotional intelligence is a very significant trait that each one of us possess. Basically, when you are referring to a leader's emotional intelligence can have an extensive power over their relationships, because leader cannot work alone. As you know that in management, we are working with people around us. So leader also cannot work alone. They need to build relationship. They need to build equations with the people around them. Basically, we can check the leader's emotional intelligence when we understand their administering ability, how they administer when they are with their team, how they're interacting with the people around them. So therein, we can understand about the role of their emotions or how they play their emotions in their organization. Let's talk the other context, that's called as what happens when suppose leaders are not emotionally intelligent. First point, most leaders basically they frequently face stressful situations because they are supposed to do umpteen number of tasks in their working day itself. So leaders whose emotional intelligence tend to act low in a demanding situations because they are unable to control their own emotions. Over there, they are unable to trace where their emotions are. They demonstrate different behaviors. We may see in organizations, they may yell towards their people, they may be blaming to the people, or they may get to be aggressive on their people, and precisely they may get to be passively aggressive. Basically, these traits or these qualities can create the same stressful environment more stressful. And whoever the workers were working over there, they will always be walking on eggshells, trying to prevent the next outburst. So this is a pathetic part of a leader, because workers who are working over there, they'll act in fear. So another point, second point, not being emotionally intelligent. Also, the problem is it can slow down. The most important criteria of an organization is the teamwork. So that means when the leaders do not have the control or grip on their own emotions and they react unsuitably, at that point of time, most of the workers, they are inclined to experience another behavioral sufferings that's called as an anxiousness about sharing informations or even communicating, because they have the fear of how the leader is going to react. Suppose say they get to be anxious because they don't know that how the leader is going to react to their feelings. So this is a problem. Third, and another important aspect is, a leader who is lacking emotional intelligence does not essentially lash out his or her co-worker or subordinates. That means not being emotionally intelligent can also demote an inability to handle a situation. So we need to be emotionally intelligent. There are a lot of leaders we can find out, they are like, you know, they have emotions with them, but they cannot express it up well. And basically, when you are unable to vent out our emotions properly, this could burden our own feelings. Leaders generally often encounter with conflicts. And the leader who is not clued about how others are going to react, what is the others' reactions to it, basically they may face a very hard time in recognizing the clash and dealing also efficiently with the resolution of it. Let's talk about it, the opposite side of the coin. What happens when the leaders are emotionally intelligent? Suppose say then when leaders are emotionally intelligent, they can build up or promote a very safe environment. And in that safe environment, employees may feel comfortable because they can take calculated risk. They can be rightly be heard about it. Now the next concept that we are supposed to discuss in terms of emotional intelligence is, what happens when leaders are emotionally intelligent? Let's revisit what is emotional intelligence over here. Emotional intelligence talks about, first of all, having an awareness about self, that is called self-awareness. Second one is like, with any individual need to create an awareness about others, that is the second thing. Third one is they need to integrate their own emotions with others' emotions. And the fourth one is they have to have a social understanding. They have to have an understanding about the society around them. So these are the four traits that an emotionally intelligent individual need to possess. So over here, when you are saying in terms of what happens when the leader possesses these traits, those four criteria of emotional intelligence, it is like leaders who are emotionally intelligent, they'll promote a safe environment. Because the safe environment means the employee will feel comfortable to take calculated risk. First of all, the employees will feel comfortable to speak out, to say what they feel, how they are progressing in their work, what kind of improvement they need, that they can share it. So they can take calculated risk. Whatever they say, they have a right to be heard, because leaders will listen to them. Basically, working collaboratively is just not an objective, but it need to be interwoven with the organizational culture. So for example, you see a company like Tata, it is not that they are talking in terms of collaborative work, they are actually following that particular collaboratively working as an organizational culture. So when a leader basically is emotionally intelligent, they can influence emotions for the good of the organization, of the group itself. They drive those emotions, they drive those positive emotions of themselves. They drive the others' aspirations, the emotions. So leaders often have to operate as agents of transformation. When you are talking about leadership, when you are talking about emotional intelligence, it is expected that they have to have the ability to move around as a transformative leader, as if they are conscious of how others will respond to the changes, how others will be responding to the required changes. They need to foresee, and also they need to plan the most suitable ways to bring out the change and to implement those changes in their organization. So therefore, emotionally intelligent leader, they do not take things personally. They always think about what is the benefit that the society will be accruing out of their emotions. So they are able to, they are supposed to move ahead with their plans without worrying about the effect that is happening on their egos. So they need to go move beyond their ego. So thank you, friends. This is all about the emotional intelligence and leadership.